I hope you're right there. Fundadora, sherry cask fine brandy from Spain. £18 a bottle there. Litre, 36%. £18 from Sainsbury's there. Winter's coming. We need to find something to keep warm instead of putting that expensive central heating on. Well, get that old glass out there. Let's have a look here. Look at that there. Where is it? It's got a cap on it. Watch this when it pours in. So you don't have a pour it up. That's alright, isn't it? Have a double. We'll not mess about here. Do it right. We'll do it right, alright. I've had to actually put light on. It's that dark. Not cold yet though. We'll just test this anyway. So I'm a lucky £18 a bottle. Nice colour to that, isn't there? Yeah, this camera right. Hang on a minute. This camera right here. Look at that colour there. Yeah, nice colour in there. Very strong smelling. Yeah, you can really smell that. That sherry casket there. Let's have a taste here. Nice taste here. Oh dear, if you like your sherry, you like this, that is strong sherry there, oh, here comes heat, that's what it's all about, that heat, a bit more. The first thing that's going to hit you is that strong sherry taste there. Not a fan of sherry. I like a nice brandy though. So a bit more wheat. I'm having little sips here because, whoa. And I'm strong sherry taste in there. But once you get over that, that warmth trickling down the back of the throat there. It's exactly what we're looking for here. Really nice heat here. Warm. Yeah, that's a lovely warmth to back of neck there. Really working its way down there. Strong sherry this. And smell sherry as well. Ah yeah. Now I'm getting used to it. It's tasting a lot better now I'm getting used to this. Just gotta get over that strong sherry taste. Try me, boy. Yeah, the sherry flavour is dissipating now. It really took me back that sherry taste in there, but it's now I'm getting used to it. It's not there as much, and that heat, that warm, it's not burning. Good shake around there. Yeah. There's some lovely, lovely heat coming off of this. Now, it's not burning. Not like your cheap whiskies and cheap whatever. It's a lovely, warming heat here. Really warm. It's really warming back of throat up here. It's just hanging about at back of throat now. It's not dissipating at all. That warmth is lovely there. This is what you want brandy for. Warming effects. Have a bit more. It's all about that warmth. Strong sherry tasting, which dissipates after you've had a few sips of it. I've only had a double here, you see, there's plenty left here. What I want to try it with, I'm going to try it with a bit of dandelion and burdock here. It's not winter yet, just to cool it off a bit there. Bit of dandelion and burdock, so I'm okay. Just a bit of. Bit of dandelion and burdock there. So have a look now. Yeah. I do like a bit of dandelion and burdock. 95 pence a 2 litre bottle there. Obviously, as soon as you put some pop in there, the heat just disappears. There's no heat here anymore. There's no heat now. No heat here. To get the benefit of the heat of the brandy, what you have to do, of course, is have it on its own. I've done a review with Bard in it. That's a nice brandy, that. Lovely heat to it. Let's just finish this off because I've got an idea here. Got a lovely heat to the here, pardon me. I've done a video of that. Put this lid back on before I forget. Bit of dandelion and bird on there. Nice. So I like that. If you like your sherry, this is definitely a brandy you want to be considering because it's a very strong sherry taste here. But you've got that lovely heat coming through. All that heat coming through the stays there as well. It doesn't disappear. I've got an idea here. What we'll do, let's get rid of this. Try something different. We'll try it with some ice. Now, try me bartonet with some ice. It were absolutely extraordinary with that ice there. It were hot and it were cold at the same time. Amazing. Good bird in there. I'll try this sherry one out there. This one. What I'm going to do here is get a few ice balls. I'm going. Nice little ball squares, whatever. These ices in there. What's in there? Is there enough in there? Yeah, there's enough in there. Let's try it with a bit of ice. I'm going to this brandy there. Nice single brandy. Don't want too much here. Not required here. And put one more ice cube in. How do they? Spin the. Let's spin around a bit. Spin around. You see the ugly ice cubes. Just wanna water it down a bit because it's very strong tasting that cherry there. Very magnificent warming from it. Hey, hang on a minute. I'm not too sure of this. I had it with bartonet and ice. It worked really well. That bartonet with ice was lovely. I'm not so sure this is working with ice, you know. With the bardonet, I'd get the heat and the cold at the same time. It'd be a lovely, lovely concoction with ice. Really works well together, but it's fun to do with it. Looking for a warming brandy for winter months here. It's fun to do it. I'm not getting any heat at all here. Just put that in. The bardonet, you get the heat and you get the cold at the same time. It were lovely, but this... Is it working at all? It's watered down the taste of the sherry, so that's good. It's a bit too strong for sherry for me here. But the disappointing thing is... There's no heat at all. I'm not getting any heat with the ice. The bardonet, you get the ice, and you still keep that heat. There's no heat here at all. What we're going to have to do here is try that again because there's something going off here, all right. Makes sense, that one. Let's have a bit more of the £18 a bottle from Sainsbury's. Spanish brandy. Some quick spin round there. Now, if you've had a look at my bardonet review there. once I put the bardener in with ice on its own, we had a lovely cool outside and a lovely warmth going all the way through, all the way down there. There's no heat at all. As soon as you put ice into this, just take a big scoop here. Let's have a proper look here. Yeah, I'm amazed. I'm absolutely blown away here. There is no heat whatsoever. That heat has gone. You put ice with this brand here, it waters down sherry strength. But what it doesn't do, which the Bardonette does, is it works wonders with ice because it keeps its heat. But you have outskirts of ice. There's no heat at all here. The heat has gone. It's all disappeared. I didn't expect that. I thought it'd be like your Bardonette and it'd hold its heat with that ice. So you'd have a nice cold outside and a warm centre and it'd warm you up as you drank it. No, it doesn't. This is disappointing, this. Well, I didn't expect that at all. I think I've got a crack in this glass. And oh, yeah, there, look. See that crack there? Crack in me glass. It's all the way down. Real shame, that. Very hard to replace glass, that. Is that it there, look? No, so with it. Don't matter about that cracking glass. It's there, look. I'm going to have to throw it away. Let's have a look at this cracking glass. You see it there? It's all the way down the cross then. There's where it got hit. You can see a little dot where it got hit, look. Must have done that on tap. What a disappointment. Very expensive little whiskey tumbler there. Yeah, like I was saying. Pardon me. There's no heat at all, won't you? Once you put the ice with this fun to do it, the heat has gone. There's no heat at all. What we're going to do here, I'm just going to try one more here. It's a nice single one. That'll do the heat. I like that little cap there. You don't get that in your Bardonette. Just to stop your overflowing brandy. We'll try it with a bit of my favourite dandelion and burdock. See if this helps the situation. Ready? I don't think it will, you know. I don't think it's going to help. Such a shame. Well, I think we're going to have to stick with Bardonette. Thought I'd try a different brand out there, do a review of that, see if we're buying right one. I think we are buying right one, which is Bardonette. Always warm. Except when you put pot wheat. Don't work with pot Bardonette if you want that warm. But with ice, it's a wonderful beverage. Because it's warm and cold at the same time. Now, of course, the sherry flavour's gone. The brandy's dropped off. There's no heat whatsoever. Now, I put that dandelion and burdock in. But it's a lovely flavour, dandelion and burdock. I like a bit of dandelion and burdock. Tastes nice with dandelion there. Gets rid of that strong sherry there. But I didn't expect that ice to totally destroy the warmth of that brandy. Which it has done. Shocking here. Very surprising there. Especially after I've tried it with the old Bardonette. And that were wondrous. Well, I reckon that's too weak. Well, just put a bit more in there. Put too much dandelion and burdock. Really taking over that glass there. A bit more in there. Yeah, Sunday Christmas. You got to get right brandy rigged up here. And I think they're... There's no doubt about it. Have I got one in stock here? No, I ain't got one. I ain't got a spare Bardonette there just to show you. You can look at a video if you want to know anyway. I didn't expect the ice to totally destroy the warmth of the brandy. So disappointing there. Flavour's gone now, all I'm getting is the old dandelion and burdock, which is good. The sherry in this is strong sherry, very strong sherry there. Really overpotent, but the warmth on it though, without the ice on its toddy. The warmth on the Thunder Door on its own is lovely. and it really hangs about back at throat there. It hangs about, keeps you warm. Now with the bardonette doesn't hang about. It just goes all the way down, then it comes all the way back up. All that warmth, it'll just come back up. Absolutely magnificent. This sits at the back of your throat there, and it'll hang about there. A lovely warmth, just like the bardonette. But this funner door, it can't handle ice. Does not improve the brandy of the ice at all. Just water's flavour of sherry down there. And it totally destroys the heat, the warmth of the brandy. And this time of year, winter's coming. That's what you get the brandy for. The warmth. So I don't think this is going to be. I don't think this is good enough for winter. Yeah. I think we've got a winner here in Bardonette, because Bardonette, you can give it all the ice you want, it'll still keep that lovely heat going. It's not working, it doesn't keep any heat whatsoever here. It's put the fire out. As soon as you put that ice in, that fire's gone. And it is a very, I keep saying it, but it is a very strong tasting sherry. No doubt about that. No doubt about that, alright. Well, I don't like to see waste. There's a bit there. Look, that's thick. I don't like to see waste. But I think I'm going to have to throw this ice away. Because if I pour another one in there with icing, throw it away. I have to throw some ice away. I don't like throwing out away here, but this brandy doesn't appreciate. Doesn't appreciate that ice around here. Doesn't appreciate it at all. It does not want ice. You want the warmth, you cannot have ice with it. It just destroys the ice, the cold. It destroys the heat, the ice. I'll get it right in a minute. Let's try it now. Let's try it again now, without any ice or any pop there. Just to get back where we started from there, just to be sure. Yeah, I forgot. Totally forgot when I first tried it on its own there. Very strong sherry taste, and it took a few sips before I got used to that taste. And as I tried it with ice and flavoured dandelion and burdock there, I've just had it there, and that sherry's really engaged. It's really strong. Try a bit, boy. For me, that sherry's too strong. If I were going to drink this on a regular basis, I'd have no option but to have a bit of pop and ice with that just to dilute that sherry taste, because it's a strong tasting sherry, that. Let's try this bit more. It's a strong tasting sherry. Yeah, I went a bit all over the shop there, but it's a strong, strong tasting sherry there. Really strong. And I can't put any ice in it because I always eat. Yeah. I'm going to have to put some dandelion and burdock in there, because that sherry's back to where it's down. It's really strong. I'm not keen on that strong sherry taste, Lee. Not keen on that at all. Yeah, it's all bare now. That sherry's just too strong. I'm not a sherry here. I'm a brandy here. When I get this, I'm not messing about no more. It cannot handle ice. The heat, the warmth of the brandy goes immediately you give it any ice. The sherry is strong on its own. So I need to water that down with some pop there. Or you put ice in to water it down. Or water, whatever you prefer, but it's a strong sherry. I'm going to give this a basic 6.5 out of 10. I'm not going to mess about here. It can't hold. cannot handle ice, if you can't handle ice, not like the old bird in it can. Yeah, can't handle ice. I'm going to give it a 6.5 out of 10, is that what I just said, mate? If you like your sherry, I mean, you probably want to be trying this brandy out, but if you put ice with it, the heat's gone, the warmth's gone. And that's the whole point of having a brandy, a nice warming effect. You can't give it any ice where you're barding it, you can. And that, I prefer barding it to you, there's no messing about it. It's too much sherry for me. I want some ice, barding it. Right, 6.5 out of 10 right there. Cheerio, Lee.